Hello. In the previous session, we learned SSB modulation, its advantages and disadvantages. In today's session, we'll understand VSB modulation. The SSB modulation is not an appropriate way of modulation when the message signal contains significant components at extremely low frequencies, because in such cases, the upper and the lower sidebands meet at the carrier frequency and it is difficult to isolate one sideband. To overcome this difficulty, the modulation technique known as vestigial sideband modulation, VSB, is used. In this technique, one sideband is passed almost completely, whereas just a trace or vestige of another sideband is retained. This is the compromise between SSB modulation and DSB-SC modulation. This figure shows the spectrum of VSB modulated wave S of t along with the message signal M of t. Here, LSB is modified into vestigial sideband. The amount removed from the USB compensates for the transmitted vestige of LSB. The bandwidth of VSB modulated wave is given as bandwidth is equal to FV plus W, where W is the message bandwidth and FV is the width of the VSB. Since FV is much less than W, the VSB requires bandwidth almost equal to SSB transmission. The generation of VSB signal is as shown in the figure. Here the output of the product modulator is S of t is equal to AC cos of 2 pi FCT into M of t. This DSB-SC signal is applied to a sideband shaping filter. The filter will pass the wanted sidebands as it is and the vestige of the unwanted sideband. Let H of f denote the transfer function of a sideband shaping filter. Hence, VSB modulated wave is given by the equation as follows. The demodulation of VSB modulated waves can be achieved by passing VSB waves through a coherent detector and then determining the necessary condition of the detector output to provide an undistorted version of original signal M of t. The figure shows the VSB signal S of t is multiplied by a locally generated carrier signal with unit amplitude AC dash is equal to 1, which is synchronous with the carrier wave AC cos of 2 pi FCT. We have the output of the modulator as shown. The output of the product modulator is later fed to the low pass filter. Thus, the output V naught f is given as AC by 2 M of f H of f minus FC plus H of f plus FC. The spectrum for V of f and V naught of f is as shown. In the next session, we'll look into frequency translation and FDM system. Thank you. Happy learning.